Hi, this is Anne for Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to talk about the rectangular grid tool and the polar grid tool, and both of those can be found right underneath the line segment tool here and here. So first we'll talk about the rectangular grid tool, and we'll select this one. And I'm going to show you how to create this graphic, but I want to do a few more basic things first. So I'm going to get a new artboard going here. And I'm going to just click and drag with the rectangular grid tool. If I use C, it moves my dividers to the right. And if I hit X, it moves them to the left. Also, you can use F and V to do up and down with these. When you're doing this, it's the same as letting go and then double clicking this and changing your skew. So this would mean you have more on the top side. And this one you have more on the right side. So I generally just leave these at zero. If you want to set up your grid, you can double click here too and get this same dialog box. And you can say how big you want your grid to be. You can say the number of horizontal dividers. Let's go ahead and make it 4, and then we'll have vertical dividers at 7. And then when you drag it, that's how many vertical and horizontal dividers you have, which makes it really easy. This does not behave really like a real table like it would in InDesign. You can't really fill these with stuff, but I can show you a way to kind of modify this to do that, and we'll do that next. So I am going to hit D. When I did that, I gave this a white fill and a black stroke. The way these grids are, you can change the whole grid itself. So I'm going to give it a fill of blue, and I'm going to give it an outline of black, and maybe we'll make that outline a little bit bigger. But you can't do an individual piece because it's not separated out that way. When we build this grid, I'll show you a way to make each of those pieces separate. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to delete these, and then we'll build this grid. So I'm going to double click my rectangular grid tool, and for horizontal dividers, I only want 2. Those are right there. And then 4 vertical dividers. I don't want any skew at all, so I'll say okay. And I'll just draw this here. Okay, and I automatically get a blue fill and a black outline because that's what was used last. And I think I'll just make that white fill and black outline by hitting D. Okay, so if we click off of this, you can see a white fill and black outline. I want to get this to a point where I can start filling these with different colors. So to do that, I'll come down here to my Pathfinder, and if that's not open, just go to Window, Pathfinder. And then I'll click this second one on the bottom called Trim. Okay, and now each of these should be its own piece, and as you can see, they are. They're also grouped, and that's something I like to leave alone, but you can definitely ungroup them if you're finding you don't like that. I want to get rid of these 3, so I'm going to hit Shift-M, and then I'll hold Option or Alt, and just click across those 3. And now we just have the ones you see here. And now I'll start filling these. Well, I'll go ahead and hit D so we can see what's going on. I'll start filling these with color. We'll hit green for that. And I'll get some other different colors in here just to match what I've got over there. Now I want to show you how to fill these other spaces with images. So I've already got some images saved. So I'm just going to File, Place. And I'll grab this one right here and place it. And I want to make it about the size, maybe a little bigger than my square. Okay, so there it is. I'm going to send it to the back. That's Shift Command left bracket, or Shift Control left bracket if you're on a PC. And I'll use my A tool, hold Shift, and click this. Your A tool is your direct selection tool. You can also use your group selection tool. So I've got both of those highlighted. And now I'm going to hit Command 7. And when I do that, it says you can't combine these objects because they're within different groups. So I'm going to say OK. And now I'm going to Command X and then Command F to paste in front. So both of these objects have been cut and then pasted, so they're no longer in their groups. And now I'm going to hit Command 7. And as you can see, you have the image here. Now, I really recommend doing this type of grid work within InDesign instead of Illustrator, but sometimes it's just faster to do it in Illustrator if you're only going to be doing a small thing like this. I'm going to hit my A tool, the direct selection, click once here, and just increase this a little bit by holding shift and pulling on the edges. Okay, now I'm going to get the picture that goes in here by placing. There it is. And I'll just do the same thing. There it is. I'm going to rotate this one a little bit. I'm going to send it back, shift, command, left bracket. I will hold shift and click once on the white block. Then I'm going to command X and paste in front. And now we'll hit command 7 to mask it. I'll go ahead and get these other images in here. Okay, now we're really close. I'm gonna go ahead and type out I love me some grids, and I'll make a copy for the word grids so it's easier to resize. I have a key command set up for changing the case, and it's command U. You can also go to type, change case to uppercase here. So we'll make this a little bit smaller. And then we'll resize everything together. I'll click on this one and then use my eye tool to grab this dark gray color and a green color. Now, as you can see, it's adding an outline to everything because these still have black outlines on them. So I'm going to just select the whole graphic and I'm going to bring the outline to the front by hitting X. And then I'm going to hit question mark to clear that off of there. So now nothing has a black outline anymore. And that is how you make a grid with the rectangular grid and get images in it and be able to change the colors in it. Let's move on to the polar grid tool. Now this tool, you can also set how many concentric circles you want and those kinds of things and how many dividers here. So let's double click here. I'm going to put 5 concentric dividers and 7 radial dividers. And now we'll just hold shift and we'll pull it out to here. I'm going to hit D so we can see what's going on. That'll give it a white fill and a black outline. If you hit shift M at this point, you can start combining things. We'll just highlight these. Whatever you highlight, those will combine, and that can be helpful if you're wanting to create some sort of maze look or something like that. Really, the main thing I use the polar grid tool for is to create images like this one over here. It is really super helpful for that. Sometimes when you're creating these things, you'll have your circles made and you need 8, and so you're like, okay, let's put 8 around here. And that actually works pretty well because it would be easy to figure out where 8 should go. But when you have a number like 7, it's hard to guess where exactly those circles should lie. And that is where the polar grid tool comes in and makes everything really easy. So I'm going to open the polar grid tool, double click it by double clicking it. I'm going to change the concentric dividers to 0 and leave the radial dividers at 7. So now when I create this, I'm holding Option or Alt and Shift. That way it goes straight from the center and is also perfect circle. Okay, so now I have 7 dividers within here, and now I know exactly where I can put my circles if I'm making a graphic like this to call out 7 different parts of a hole or something like that. And now you can keep this as it is, or you can make it guides by hitting command 5. And that's what we're going to do today. And now I know exactly where to put my little circles around this edge. So I'll hit L for the circle tool. I'll hold shift and option, get right on that anchor and draw my first circle. And now it's just a matter of holding Option or Alt and placing it on that next intersection. And then the same thing here until you have them all the way around. Then you can go ahead and make all the other changes that you need to. If you hadn't already made this into guides, I'll just show you how easy it is to use what's already existing here. I'm going to grab just these inner things with my Q tool. The Q is the lasso tool. So I'll just grab them like this, and I will X, delete the rest of that, and then paste in front. So now I have all the little lines connecting the main dot. I'm not going to go ahead and show you all of this. It's basically just a bunch of circles, and I think you guys can probably figure it out for yourselves. But those are the main parts that I don't think are as obvious. So anyway, let me know what you're working on and how the polar grid has helped you, or if you have any questions about it at all, please leave a question in the comment section below, and I will see you next Thursday. Thanks, guys.